is Christopher with AG Productions, and welcome to another edition of Friday Afternoon in Figures. Very cold day in Alabama, so if you're wondering why I'm wearing long sleeves underneath my Aloha shirt, now you know why. Today we're going to talk about I'm going to say it's a small company. They're bigger than most small companies, though, but they've got a very cool name. Today we're going to talking about Black Scorpion Miniatures. If you've never heard of Black Scorpion, they've been around for a little bit of time, a couple of years now, as far as I know. And they're based out of the UK, and they have a very, very nice range of models. They've got about 150 miniatures total, spread over roughly about 110 different sets, all right? But they have a very wide range of models. They've got some really cool stuff that a lot of companies don't offer. They've got a very nice collection of what most people would refer to as Blood Bowl. It's sort of the sort of fantasy football type league. They have a huge selection of Old West miniatures, which I really love because it's very rare nowadays anyway, other than with like something like Foundry miniatures, to see any Western models. Crucible used to produce some, but Crucible, I don't even think they exist anymore. I think Raffam took to Crucible. Anyway, it doesn't matter. But they do have a very nice line of like cowboys and Indians, if you will. They got some very good fantasy figures, very cool pirate models. Got a nice line of about five or six different alien miniatures. And one of the things that I really like about this company is their giant miniature. Now, they've got a giant model that dwarfs the Warhammer giant. This thing is almost an entire foot tall. It's about 9 inches tall. Really, just a massive, massive figure. And very, very cool looking, too. Very well sculpted. Doesn't have that sort of, I just stepped off the short bus look that the Games Workshop giant has nowadays. I don't know why they changed that, by the way. The Marauder giant looked fine back when Marauder miniatures produced it, and then they came up with the one that had the club with the like the gravestone on it. That one looked fine too, and then they changed it to this thing like, and you know, okay, maybe giants are supposed to look like that, but he looks like an idiot, you know. I don't know. Anyway, Black Scorpion, very cool company. Most of their miniatures are metal. There are a few of them that are resin cast, though. No plastic stuff, by the way, other than the bases, of course. But you're welcome to use your own bases. They've got some very, very nice painters working for them, so you guys are going to see some really beautifully painted models. Plus, as of October 5th of this year, they're actually looking for an artist. And I believe what they're looking for is an actual 2D artist and not a like a miniature painter or a sculptor. I think what they're looking to do is do some stuff for some advertising and things like that. So if you're a 2D painter or drawer, is that a word? Drawer? All right. If you are a drawer or a painter, you might be interested in even maybe submitting some work over to Black Scorpion. But anyway, take a look at the still pics at the end because there's some really, really nice miniatures over there. All the miniatures they have are done in basically 32mm scale. There's a few 54mm, which makes them slightly larger than your standard Warhammer model. Warhammer's generally done in 28mm fantasy, which puts it about the 30mm range, so it's just a tiny, tiny bit bigger than your standard Warhammer or 40K style miniature. But very nice line of models. Definitely go check them out. Their website is blackscorpionminiatures.com. Link will be down there in the video description section. And that's about it, guys. Definitely check out the still pics at the end and enjoy Black Scorpion Miniatures. That's it for today. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day. And I will see you guys in tomorrow's Ask a Painter, which won't really necessarily be an Ask a Painter. It's actually going to be the review or the recommendations, if you will, of what to take as far as classes go at this year's 2011 Adepticon. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.